Hi, I'm Jim Self, and welcome to my garage. Today, I'm going to walk you through a basic trailer inspection. Going through these steps is going to ensure that you're less likely to have a breakdown on the road. First one, since tires happen to be one of the top failures, we're going to go through and we're going to walk around the trailer. We're going to check all the lug nuts. There actually is torque specifications for these. You can find in some of the owner's manuals. If they are loose, jack it up, take the weight off, and get them all torqued evenly. Look for any weather cracking, any gouges or nicks where you may have run over an object. Check your tread depth. Make sure you got good tread on there, no knots or anything that looks like it might be a ruptured cord or anything. If you have a flat, you always want to have a spare available, and you want to make sure that it's inflated properly and in good condition as well. So, two trailer bearings. Again, another major failure area. Very common misbelief with these things is if you have these and you just keep greasing them, you never have to do anything else. Even with these bearing buddies, you still need to remove the hubs, inspect the seals, and repack the bearings in these hubs on a fairly regular basis. Depending on how much you tow your trailer, you might be able to get by with it every couple of years. You can see the springs inside the hub here. When these are fully lubricated, those springs will be compressed. And even with these, you got to be very cautious not to over lubricate, because if you put too much grease in here, what you're doing is forcing that grease through the seal on the back side of the hub and actually doing damage to the seal, which will allow water to intrude into the hub and damage the bearings. This is an excellent product for these applications because these are in and out of the water all the time. It's aluminum complex base grease, so it's the waterproof characteristic of this product is ideal for this application. This was recently pulled out of a trailer hub. They were not maintaining it. You can see how rusty it is. The rollers are all falling out. Had this gone any longer, this trailer would have been sitting alongside the road somewhere waiting for emergency services to help them out. Okay. One additional check you can make on your trailer bearings, if you're not going to disassemble the hub and repack them at this time, put a jack under the trailer, raise the wheel up to where it's not touching on the ground, and give it a good spin. It should spin freely without making any noise. Also, there shouldn't be any back and forth movement. That would indicate that the lock nut in here needs to be tightened up a little bit. 5-10 miles down the road, just pull over and check the hubs and make sure they're not hot. That would be a sign that there may be a little bit of bearing problem in there. So next, let's move on to spring inspection, which is another leading cause of failures on the road. Overall, structurally, it's still looking pretty good. Areas you want to inspect here is the welds, where the leaf springs attach to the frame, the springs themselves, as well as the U-bolts underneath here where it connects to the axle. And then again, next, the axle overall, if you want to look it over. Sometimes these things will actually rust from the inside out. So it's not a bad idea to get a hammer, kind of tap on them, make sure they sound fairly solid. Give them a good thorough inspection. All right, next we're going to move up here to the front of the trailer. As you can see, is this when this trailer was updated, it had a new coupler installed, but it's something you still want to lubricate and service. Best place to start is right here on your hitch ball. Give this a good coat of grease because this is actually the pivot point and receives a lot of stress as you're towing. So get a little bit up inside the receiver here itself. Then I recommend for the pivot points, Bel-Ray 6-in-1 lubricant. This is a phenomenal product. It's got really good corrosion inhibiting characteristics. It's a penetrating oil, and it just does a really good job in light duty applications here. So what we're going to do is just spray a little bit here in some of the pivot points. We're going to pull the trail up here and just connect it. It works nice and smooth. I'm going to check and make sure there's no play here. Next, the tongue jack. Often neglected. These can be lubricated. There's a set of gears inside this cap. So as you look down inside here, you'll see the gears. Again, an ideal application for this Bel-Ray waterproof grease because this is exposed to the rain and elements throughout the year. So just put a good dab on there. Work it into the gears. And then also it's a good idea to raise the jack up and lubricate the shaft here itself. So this will help just make this thing crank a lot easier. Want to inspect our safety chains. These actually are in pretty good shape. A little surface rust, not really hurting anything. If you wanted to prevent those from rusting, Bel-Ray actually makes a rust preventative coating. Another great product here. You can spray this on any metal surface. You know, I could even spray the frame here, but just give it a little coat, even if it's already rusty. No need to clean them first. This will prevent that rust from going any further. Again, it can be used on any metal part throughout the trailer. This is a new plug that was installed in pretty good shape, but again, if you have a little corrosion on there, which is very common as these things sit through the winter, Bel-Ray's electrical contact cleaner is a great product for maintaining these connections. So just put a little in there. Evaporates fairly quick and then very cleanly. It doesn't leave any residue behind. A really good degreaser. If you have any excess grease buildup on things, you can use this electrical contact cleaner for that as well. Battery connections in your boat, multitude of uses for this. Next, we'll go to the winch strap here. This isn't something you typically want to put a heavy lubricant on. You can use the waterproof grease, or what I like to do is just give it a little shot of the Bel-Ray 6-in-1 lubricant. Make sure your latching mechanism here is lubricated and working freely. It's a good idea to pull it all the way out. Make sure there's no frays or tears in here, because if this thing fails, it can cause you to lose your boat. One additional point I like to inspect on the trailer is the bunks. These carpeted pads here help protect the hull. It's very, very common for these to wear thin from the boat riding on to the trailer when they're dry. Front one here is not too bad of shape. Yes, looks like this carpet here is it's coming loose. I actually have a wooden 2x4 here that's rotted out, so it's time to get this one replaced. I mean, I recommend you do them all while you're at it, because if this one's this bad, the other one's not going to be far behind it. All right, next we want to step back here and we want to inspect the lights. This particular trailer had the tail lights upgraded to LEDs recently, which I really highly recommend. It eliminates a lot of the traditional issues you have with bulbs and stuff going in and out of the water. Left turn. Okay. Right turn. Brakes. Tail lights. Okay, with tail lights on, we want to also check the side marker lights. The side marker on most trailers, at least one location on the side. This one's functioning good. While we're at it, just double check the registration on your plates. I happen to have a sticker here, and we're going to go ahead and update this to make sure we don't get a ticket for an expired plate on our next fishing trip here. If you want to have a complete list of recommended tools we advise you to carry in your vehicle, check the list coming up here on the video or on our website. So if you do have a breakdown on the road, you're prepared. Thanks for watching. Have a safe boating season and hopefully no breakdowns on the road.